here we want to hide this. Let's bring it into another layer that will be called emitter sun. We can take it out. We can bring this to a gray color. I am simulating this with PRTs. So Krakatoa, PRT loader. If you don't have PRT loader, download it. You can download the demo. Let's create with the demo. It worked. I have the demo here and you can load any particles. You don't need a license, only you need a license for render as a particle. But the intention is to mesh it with Frost, so all good. PRT loader. Let's create it. There. It will start will create always a folder called cache, and it will create a name, the same name as your project name. So here we have the particles that is storm is still simulating, and we can load them. Use no transform, turn it off if you want to see the particles in place. And they are here. What we want to do is viewport, let's display 100% of the particles. It's not so much. And the cool stuff is that a storm is saving the particles in with the color. So it's saving colors, it's saving original positions. You can do a lot of things with magmaflow. As you can see, we keep all the colors coming from storm. We get the red colors when the particles are asleep, and we get the blue colors when the particles are activated. And we can use this in magmaflow. That's why PRT is so powerful. Let's say that if we need to send this to COM, you don't want to mesh all the particles, so it will be slower, but mostly it's like for a COM purpose, you will not like to have this red. It's very easy to fix it here on magmaflow. You only need to have a magma select, and that's what I create. Basically, we load the colors that comes from a storm, we decompose RGB, we take the red that it's X, and we say that everything that it's higher than 0.5, so it's red, go to selection. Then we can do, we can activate that, and we can activate Krakatoa delete. Everything that it's selected will be deleted, so all the red particles are deleted. Now we have way less particles, and only the particles that we are interested on. In top of that, in magma color, right now I am reading the color that comes from storm, but you can have a text map. Text map, if you plug it into the viewport color, and also I am using emission position. If you do, if you do IC, you can see all the data that comes from storm. There is position, velocity, color, selection, ID. Selection it's coming from magmaflow. Then we have emission position, emitter ID, number of constraints. We have a lot of data that comes from a storm. And emission position, it's the position of each particle when they are born. So they are not moving. This way, if you add any texture on it, it will be fixed and static onto the particles. And we can send this to the viewport color. So we display it on viewport, and also we save it onto a mapping channel. We save it into mapping channel 2. Because we save the vertex color to map channel 2, if you want to load this into Frost, you only need to apply a vertex material map channel color with the same index that you saved and plug it onto whatever color you want to use it. So then each particle will get the color that it's assigned as you see it on the viewport. That's very easy to do. In Frost, for example, you can assign this to Frost. It will render each of these colors. You can have multiple map channels with different index to control reflections, glossiness, whatever. It's really powerful. You can animate that in magmaflow, whatever. Now, how we will do that, because we don't have Frost and I don't want to use anything that you need to pay or install extra. So how we will do that in Max without any plugins? If you don't use Frost, I will use ThinkingParticles or Tyflow. But because I don't want to use anything extra, I will use Pflow. And Pflow is the worst ever. Also, keep in mind that if you use Frost, this animation, because it's Krakatoa, it's loading a single frame. Any particle system needs to load each single frame before. So it's way slow and it's a pain, specifically in Pflow, because we are loading over 1 million particles. So how we will do it, if I open the particle view, is that they have a Krakatoa PRT berth. This comes with Krakatoa. If you install the demo, you will have this. You can select your PRT, it will load. Then with the Krakatoa, you need a Krakatoa update, so it keeps updating. Remember to select the velocity. If you don't select velocity, you will not have Korg motion blur. Mapping channel 2, I don't found that then it's working. I will talk about it then later. I have a rotation, so we have different particles, the shapes are rotated differently. I have Arnold shape. If you don't have this operator, you need to update to the latest Arnold. What this does is to create a procedural from whatever mesh. So instead of creating shape instance, it's shape instance is not creating really an instance. At the end, it will create a big mesh with everything. This is slow and takes a lot of RAM. Arnold shape is way faster. Problem is that it's super limited. We don't have a scale, and material frequency even it will not work. I need to talk with the guys from Autodesk. This is not working really good if you need to apply more than one material. But that's what we have. If you don't have Arnold shape, if you don't have so many particles, you can use shape instance, but keep in mind that you will use much more RAM and it will be much slower to prepare all this mesh. Overall, with this we can render. It will be slow. When you activate that, you will see that it needs to pre-calculate everything, loads each particle, convert it to PRT. It's needing to do a lot of extra steps that they are not needed. If you have frost, you will render this in 4 seconds. With Pflow, can take up to 2 minutes. So it's what we have. When we will get Bifrost, hopefully we will be able to instance using Bifrost and will be way, way faster when we can load PRTs into Bifrost. So that's how we do it right now. Thank you guys a lot to follow this tutorial. I hope that you enjoy it and you learn something new. Enter on the forum, effectivetechnicaldirectors.com, and ask whatever you need. If you want that I cover more things related to MagmaFlow, it's really powerful. We can do a lot of things with MagmaFlow. If you want that I do a tutorial specific with Frost, so I can cover that. But I hope that you like it and see you soon, guys.